Hello everyone, welcome to MESS e-learning channel. In this lecture, we'll solve problem on parallel force system in a coplanar forces. So now you can see the example here, and the question reads that we have to locate and replace the whole system by a resultant force. So when we start solving a parallel force system, so our first step would be to find the resultant, and the resultant would be summation of forces. Now why only summation of forces? Because as this is a parallel force system, the forces would be in a single direction, whether it can be in x direction or it can be in y direction. The next step would be to find moment about a point. Summation of moment about a point. So why I have written O? So it can be any point that we select, and from that point we can find moment, unless and until it is not mentioned in the question. Then the third step would be to find distance of R in the system from the point where we have found out the moment. Then the fourth step would be to locate R in the system. So now I will move on to the first step. So R is equal to summation of forces would be equal to, according to sign convention we have to do. So this is going in the downward direction, so it would be minus 70. Then this is going in upward direction, so it would be plus 100, again plus 50, minus 86, minus 34, and plus 90. If you calculate this, the answer comes out to be 50 Newton, and as it is the positive value, the resultant forces will be in upward direction. Then the next step is to find the moment. So we have to find the moment of all the forces in the system. So for finding moment of all the forces in system, we have considered our base point to be O. So from O point, we'll find all the moments for the all the available forces in the system. So from point O, if you see, the first force is 70, but moment is force into perpendicular distance, and this doesn't have a perpendicular distance. That means the perpendicular distance here is 0. So for 70 Newton, there is no moment, so it will become 0. Next is force that is going upwards in the upward direction, that is 100. So I keep my finger here. If I see, this is the anti-clockwise force. And as in the last lecture, I have said that anti-clockwise force, we take it as positive. So this would be 100 into, this will be the perpendicular distance for the 100 Newton force. So it would be 100 into 1.5. The next force is 50. So this is also in the anti-clockwise direction. So it would be positive. It would be 50 into, and the perpendicular distance would be this. So this would be 3.5. Then the next is this force. If I see, this is clockwise direction. So it would be minus 86 into 6.5. Because this would be the perpendicular distance from O. Then the next value is 34, which is also in the clockwise direction. So it would be minus 34 into the total distance, that is 6.578. The next force is 90. So 90 is going in the anti-clockwise direction. So it would be plus 90 into the complete distance is 10. So this will be our moment for all the forces. then if you calculate this, you get the answer to be 394 Newton meter. Why Newton meter? Because this is force into perpendicular distance. Now our next step is to find the distance where this R would be located. Now for finding the distance, we apply Varignon's theorem. So it is moment of all the forces about the point is equal to moment of the resultant force about the same point. So it would be moment of all the forces about a point O, which we already found, is equal to moment of resultant force about the same point. So it would be R into D. So our moment of all the forces is 394 equals to R is 10, R is 50 into D. So if we calculate D from here, we would get 7.88 meters. Now to locate it, what we'll do is we'll just draw the representative of the given beam. This is our point from where I have found the moment. So our resultant is 50 Newton at 7.88 distance positive. So at a distance of 7.88, let's say this is my distance 7.88 meter. So here our resultant force will be located. But if we see the value here, this is positive value. So positive means it is anti-clockwise. So if it has to be anti-clockwise from O, our 50 Newton will be like this. So if we see the direction of the force from O, it would be anti-clockwise. So if in the same question, the question was to be replace the whole system by a force and a couple, let's say at point A here. So now what we have to do is, we know that whatever resultant we find or whatever couple we find, it is going to be placed at A point, because they have said in the question that replace the whole system by a force and a couple at point A. So we'll start solving for that. So here the first step would be the same, the resultant. So as it is the same example, the resultant would remain same. Then the second step would be finding moment at A. Why A? Because we have to replace our system by a couple at point A. So couple is also a moment. Now we'll start with finding the moment at point A. So from point A, if I see, my 70 Newton force is going in an anti-clockwise direction. So it would be 70 into the distance from A, now we'll see. So it is 3.5. The next force is 100 Newton force, which will be clockwise from A. So it would be minus 100 into the distance is 2. Now the next force is 50 Newton, which is located at A. So there will be no perpendicular distance for this force from A. So that would become 0. Now there is a next force that is 86 Newton. So if we see the direction, it is clockwise. So it is minus 86 into 3, the distance from A. The next force, 34, so if we see, the 34 is also clockwise, so it would be 34 into 4.5. The last force is 90, which is in the anti-clockwise direction from A, so it would be plus 90 into the distance from A, that is 6.5. So if we calculate, we'll get a value of 219 Newton meter positive. So it would be anti-clockwise. So now we'll directly go and locate it, as we already know that it has to be located at point A. So here there is a representation of that same bar element. So let's say this is my point A. Now in this part, we want our force to be, force and the couple which we found out to be at point A. So at point A, I'll have my resultant force. Now resultant force is in the upward direction, so it is positive. And we have found a 50 Newton, and we found a couple which is 219 Newton meter, which also has to be at point A or about point A. So this is how we replace the whole system by a force and a couple at a given point. So in this lecture, we saw how to solve a problem on parallel force system. Thank you.